Hello and welcome to another Dragon Ball FighterZ video. Today we're breaking down Videl. While Videl might still be getting the hang of this new thing called energy, in Dragon Ball FighterZ she pretty much has every tool that you could ask for. A lot of it is unsafe, which gives me Android 17 flashbacks, but overall, I think she received a lot more love than 17 did. And it all starts with some of her unique normals. First of all, her down light hits low. So I know that's a big selling point for a lot of you. Great for high-low mix-ups, you always gotta be on the lookout for that empty jump low with Videl, because that 2L comes out pretty fast. It's a good 2L. Her standing medium is something she can do twice. You don't even need to stagger it like you do with Cell, you just kind of hold back, and she just kicks the opponent twice. For blockstrings or for combos, keep this one in mind because you're going to need it to be optimal, or just to throw your opponent off and open them up. Now, because Videl is still very new to the concept of energy, she does not throw energy blasts when you press the special attack button. Instead, she calls for Gohan, or actually, I'm sorry, the Great Saiyaman! Now, different inputs with your special button will make this Great Saiyaman do different things. For instance, just pressing the special button will make him super dash, pressing down in the special button will make him throw a key blast, good for neutral if you follow up with an assist, you can just dash in afterwards. And it works pretty much the same in the air. If you press the special button, it will just do a dive kick. And if you press down and the special button, he will do a dive kick, but he will appear immediately above the enemy. In this regard, she might remind you a little bit more of Android 18 than 17, because she has this puppet character that she can just call on a whim. And that's one of the reasons why she got a lot more love than 17 did. We're not done with her unique specials. Videl is the only character in the entire roster that does not have a reflect. Instead, she has this dodge in place, this spot dodge where she just dodges an enemy's attack. Now, you can use this in a very similar way to which you use Reflect. If you see an attack coming, you press this and then you can try to punish the opponent, or you can just keep blocking if successful, because you see there's a little circle that pops up and a little sound that plays. But if you whiff it, you will be vulnerable just like you would if someone baited your Reflect. Though this does come with some unique properties. First of all, it doesn't push the enemy backwards, which a Reflect would, so its uses might be a little bit different from a Reflect. And also, Videl ceases to exist on the stage while the frames are active, which means characters can just run through her. It's like she phases out of this plane of existence, and that is gonna open up a lot of new tech. Moving on to her heavy attacks, her 2H is bad. Vertically, it is fine. Horizontally, it doesn't have a large hitbox. Again, it feels similar to Cell's, who also got a good vertical hitbox, but a kind of a crappy one horizontally, so chances are you're gonna be whiffing this 2H a lot. And finally, if you press forward in the attack button, she does all of this. The string of attacks is fully automatic, and it is not a true block string, so it can be reflected. Very, very unsafe to use, but you can cancel it at any point into a universal overhead. So again, it's something that will mostly be used in block strings. With her unique normals out of the way, we're gonna talk about some of her specials, and we're gonna start nice and simple with Rising Eagle. Quarter circle backwards and a special button. You guys recognize this kick, you know what it does. It is a DP, which for those unversed in fighting game terminology means it is an invincible move at startup. You can use this to steal turns. If the enemy is throwing something at you, you could just press this button and you knee them in the face or the gut. It depends on how tall the character is. But if you miss it, it's got a huge recovery and it's very, very easy to punish. Videl's DP only works while on the ground. She doesn't have an aerial DP. That luxury is still reserved for other characters only. Next up, we have the Moonsault Kick with down, down and the light, medium or heavy attack versions. This is a cross-up overhead attack, and I agree with Otodoya, the name is the best thing in the world. Moonsault! You can do this move from the ground or the air. The effect is pretty much the same, and you can just do this thing forever. If the opponent's blocking or getting hit, you can just keep on doing it. This is an amazing tool for mix-up because you can put this anywhere you want on your block string, though it is an aerial attack, which means it is punishable by anti-air moves like the down heavy. Though if the opponent is spamming down heavy, most likely he will whiff because the down heavy will come out on the wrong side. Still, it is punishable, so I wouldn't really risk it without assists. The different attack buttons have different ranges and different speeds, but also different effects upon landing. The light attack version leaves the opponent in place, good for following up with a combo if you have an assist to link it into. The medium attack version bounces the opponent off the ground, so you're definitely gonna need an assist to follow up or simply use a vanish. And the heavy attack version also bounces the opponent off the ground, but leaves him much closer, which means you can just combo by yourself. You can just pick it up with a down medium. Moving on to her next special, the Frankensteiner. Again, great name. This is the command grab. Videl jumps up in the air and grabs you with her legs. Every version can be performed in a block string, but once again, because it is an aerial attack, everything is punishable by a down heavy. So do make sure you use your assists, but not too late, because if the opponent is in block stun, your command grab will not work, just like most command grabs in game. If you do land it though, the light attack version smashes your opponent's face into the ground, the medium attack version calls in for Gohan, who kicks the opponent back down to the ground, and the heavy attack version also calls in for Gohan, and you can follow it with the super dash. Now, you can also modify the medium and the heavy attack versions by holding down the button. So if you hold down the medium attack button, Gohan won't come off, it's just Videl. Same for the heavy attack button. Now, if you hold the heavy attack button, you won't be able to follow up with the super dash unless you are close to the corner, because this will cause a wall bounce, but only if you're close enough to that wall. And while in the corner, if you hold down the medium attack button, you can actually follow up with the heavy attack. And after that heavy in the corner, you can totally follow up with the super dash and continue your combo from there. And then we save the best for last. The last special we're gonna talk about is the Videl Rush, because we're gonna be here a while and you need the knowledge of the previous specials to understand this one to its full extent. Now, it all starts with quarter circle forward and an attack button. And you'll notice that the light, the medium, and the heavy attack buttons all have different ranges and different activation speeds. It all starts with this very, very simple kick. But after the activation, you can follow up with more attack buttons. If you just press the light attack button, Videl does this whole sequence, and you can follow up the sequence at the end if you call an assist to extend the combo. The second hit of that follow-up is actually an overhead. So if the opponent is blocking and you delay that second hit follow-up, you can pretty much go into a low light or into that overhead, and that is a 50-50. I repeat, after the first hit, you delay the follow-up, which is an overhead, or you go into a low light. Videl's got them 50-50s, boys. Of course, because you're using delays, this works better if you have an assist to cover that gap. And that is all while talking only about the light attack button. At any point during the string of attacks, you can press the medium attack button and Videl will do the moonsault kick. It has exactly the same properties as the medium attack version of the moonsault kick. It will bounce the opponent off the ground, still vulnerable to down heavy, so do watch out for that. Cover it with your assists. But if you do land it, you can extend it with an assist or a vanish combo. On the other hand, instead of finishing with a medium attack during that attacking string, you can just press the heavy attack, you will spend a bar of meter, and Videl will do the heavy attack version of the Frankensteiner, which, if you recall correctly, is the command grab. You can also hold down the heavy attack button to prevent the Great Saiyaman from being summoned. It just kind of depends on what you want to go for. But if you do summon the Great Saiyaman, you can just follow this up with a super dash. Now, here's the thing. This move, the Videl Rush, can be used on the ground. So on the ground, with the Videl Rush only, we have a 50-50 at startup, we have potential cross-ups with the medium attack button, or we have command grabs with a heavy attack button. Videl's mix-up is incredibly scary. Not a lot of it is safe. You can punish a lot of it, but if you do respect Videl, oh boy, you better be ready to block, to jump, to get out of some tough situations. It is not going to be easy to survive for long. And we're just talking about the grounded versions of this move. In the air, the Videl Rush changes quite a bit. Now, once you do the quarter circle forward and the input, you don't get follow-ups, so the move is a lot simpler. And it always looks like this no matter what version you use, but it does have different properties. Now, the light attack button will just kick and elbow the opponent back down, but it will not cause any sort of knockdown. The opponent will just tech right away. The medium attack version will always put the opponent into a sliding knockdown, which means Videl will always be able to get a sliding knockdown off of a vanish, off of anything. Unless the hit stun is way too high, Videl will always be able to combo into the medium attack version of this aerial Videl Rush, which is just going to give her a lot of value. And if the hit stun is very, very high, you can always use the heavy attack version because it has a faster startup and it also puts the opponent into a sliding knockdown. So even though you can't select the follow-ups for the Videl Rush in the air, it is quite an amazing tool that allows Videl to always get a sliding knockdown. This move is also Videl's assist, and it's just the activation, just the initial kick, and it behaves similar to Bardock's assist. It's really fast, not as fast as Bardock's, but close enough to that, and it does have slightly more range than Bardock's assist. So from the assist position, Videl is also going to be very useful. If you've ever used the Bardock assist, you know how useful that assist can be. It's fast, it's great for confirms, it's great for combo extensions, and Videl's works very, very similar. Moving on to her supers, Videl has got four different supers, two level ones and two level threes. Our first level one is the Rainbow Storm, which is quite the unique super. It just throws the opponent up into the air where they can tech out of trouble, no problem whatsoever. So it seems like a bad super at first, but the thing is, you can follow this up. You can follow this super up without the help of any assists. You can simply super dash and follow this up, no problem. Or you can call in for the Great Saiyaman with some of your special moves, which will allow Videl to do a same side Dragon Rush or follow up with a more damaging combo if she wishes to. issue. Also, the recent patch has nerfed damage after a level 1 super, but Videl is an exception. If you follow up the level 1 super with a combo and then end that combo with another super, her damage won't be nerfed. Neither her damage nor the DHCs that you call after that. So Videl has received the double super love pretty much at the same time that all double supers got nerfed. If you ask me, that's Bandai telling you to buy their DLC. I see what you're doing, Bandai. I can see through your measly tricks. Up next, it's another very weird level 1. This one is a counter, it's a parry. Defender of Love and Justice, Great Saiyaman, pops up to protect Videl. The first time you do this move in a match, there's this big animation, the Great Saiyaman Dance, which is not just for style points, I mean it is also for style points, but it also powers up every single move that the Great Saiyaman participates in. Now, the power-up is very slight and kind of irrelevant when you add scaling into the mix, so don't feel like you have to do this activation, don't feel like you have to use this super for Videl to be useful, because the damage increase is not that special. But because you hit your opponent with a raw level 1, the scaling is insane if you can follow it up with another super. It really is a lot of damage, so don't sleep on this super for sure. It is a counter, so if you can see your opponent pressing buttons, trying to attack you, just do it, especially if you have the meter to follow it up, because this can be devastating. This can be match-ending. And then we have two level 3 supers for Videl. First is the Justice Rush, which might be her only normal super in the entire game. The activation is very similar to Android 18's, where Videl and the Great Saiyaman will dash forward and start comboing you, and then there's a finisher, and you've got a decent Oki afterwards. Not as good as 18's, but it's good. It's decent. And then our final level 3 is Justice Revenge, which only works once Videl is knocked down, and you hold the right trigger down until you recover. The Great Saiyaman will jump into the stage, turn Super Saiyan, and Kamehameha your opponent. It's a great beam, and even if the opponent reflects, you will be safe. So it is indeed a very good wake-up option, even if it does cost 3 bars of meter. Moving on to her auto combos, her first auto combo looks like this. You can use this auto combo for a side switch, because as you might have noticed, Videl side switches. And also the third hit is a command grab, which means that after a level 3 super, you might go for a third hit command grab Oki. Kinda like Android 16, it's an option that Videl has if she wants to use it. And then for a second auto combo, if you mash the medium attack button, she does this. And because she ends in that level 1 super that we already covered, you know what to do after this. You can follow up with a super dash if you want, or go for some more tricky combos using the Great Saiyaman. And now that we know her moves, let's give out some tips on how to use her. Now, Videl's normals are weird. Outside of her down light hitting low, her normals are not that great. A lot of her stuff is not airtight, it is reflectable, it isn't safe during block strings, so she will need assists. Meaning, once again, this is a character that will shine the most when played in the point position. That said, her assist can also put her in mid, because her assist is like Bardock, and if you've played Bardock, you know how useful that assist can be. So if she is in the bench, she will not be useless. The only spot I wouldn't put her on the team is on the anchor position, because once again, a lot of her stuff is just unsafe. She will also need assists to get some proper damage after her Videl rush moves, because most of them will need assists for follow-ups, or simply, in a block string, you're gonna need those assists to make those block strings airtight, to make those block strings safe. Otherwise, Reflect and Punish, or simply Down Heavy, will get the best of you. That said, if you do have assists, Videl's options are seemingly endless. She is crazy scary if she gets you to block. First of all, she has a ton of overheads, she can switch sides at a whim, she's got command grab, she's got a low light so she can empty jump, she's got them 50-50s, boys! She is crazy, crazy scary! So even though a lot of her stuff is reflectable, a lot of her stuff is punishable by down heavy, that's why you use assists to cover that. That's why you use your assists to make up for that flaw. And if you do it correctly, even the best players in the world won't be able to block your Videl. Outside of that, she's got an amazing tool by being able to get a sliding knockdown from pretty much anywhere. Even after a level 1 super, which usually doesn't let you get a sliding knockdown with the Videl rush in the air, if you finish the combo with down heavy into the heavy attack version of her command grab, you will spend an extra bar of meter, but you will always, always get a sliding knockdown no matter the situation. Videl is always ready to put you in a sliding knockdown position and start over the pressure, which is the scary scariest thing about this character is her pressure. So being able to put you in a sliding knockdown and not give you a moment's rest is incredibly scary if you're blocking against Videl. Plus, outside of her 50-50s and crazy mix-ups, she's got a DP to steal your turns. She's got same side snapbacks. And her reflect, which is not a reflect, is a spot dodge, is super weird, but the fact that she's the only one that has this ability makes it so that when you use it, most players are not expecting the results. They are not respecting the outcome, so if you familiarize yourself with this ability, you can catch a lot of fools off guard. Thank you for watching another character breakdown for Dragon Ball FighterZ. Videl is so much fun, and also crazy scary, but she requires a lot of practice to make her block strings airtight, to make her pressure that flawless. So if you do decide to buy Videl, just know ahead of time you're gonna need that lab time, baby. All the videos, all the live streams on the channel are brought to you by the premium members. I wouldn't be able to do what I do without your support, so thank you guys so much for your support. If you're not a premium member yet, you can become one. Just head over to Patreon, check out your options, and I look forward to meeting you on our Discord server. But as always, thank you very much for watching. My name is Globku, and I'll see you guys next time. Boy.